Good evening to all of you students. Today I am going to explain about the ring. Ring is also an algebraic structure of the group theory. So today we will study about the ring. So first of all, you will see the definition of the ring. Ring is nothing but it is also a set. It is also a set that have certain properties. So earlier we have seen that in a group that contains a single binary operation, but in ring this is a set that contains two binary operations, that is binary addition and binary multiplication. So first we will define it. It can be defined as, this is a set R equipped with two binary operations, that is addition and multiplication. That is to say, we can write it as the algebraic structure. This is R, comma, plus, comma, dot. Dot here, this is showing the multiplication. This is called a ring if following properties are satisfied. So the first property is R, comma, plus is an abelian group. This is the first property, that the set with binary addition should be an abelian group. This should be an abelian group. We have already known, we have already seen that the properties of group, there are normally some properties, like we will see the first property is, closure property. That is to say, if A comma B belongs to R, then A plus B should also belong to R. Then we say this set will be closed with respect to the binary addition. So this is first property of group. And the second property is associative property. This is associative property. That is to say, for all A comma B comma C belongs to R, we will have A plus B plus C equals to A plus B plus C. So it should be equal to this. So it will have the associative property. And the third property is the property of identity element. So it will have the identity element. Means for all A belongs to R, there will be an element that will also belong to this, and it will be A plus 0 equals to A equals to 0 plus A. This is additive identity. Means 0 is the identity element here, because we are taking the plus, this is binary addition. So this is additive identity. So this is third property, and the fourth property is, this is inverse property. Means it will also have inverse element for all A belongs to R. There will be an element that will be the inverse of A. That is to say, we will have A plus minus A equals to 0 equals to minus A plus A. This is additive inverse. So if this set contains A, then it will also contain minus A. And this is the additive inverse. And the fifth property is commutative property.
property. That is to say, if A comma B belongs to R, then A plus B equals to B plus A. This is commutative law. If we have two elements that belongs to R, then we will have A plus B equals to B plus A. Means these five properties, these are the properties of abelian group. So it will be, this set will be an abelian group. And the second is R comma dot is R semi group. Means it will be a semi group. For this binary multiplication, it will have, we know there are normally two properties of the semi group. First is closure property, and the second property is associative property. So first is closure property means for all A comma B belongs to R, we will have A dot B belongs to R. So A dot B will also belongs to R. It means this set is closed with respect to the binary multiplication. So it means it will have the, it will hold the closure property. And the second is, this is associative. Associative property will also be held by the semi group if A comma B comma C belongs to R, then A dot B dot C equals to A dot B dot C. For associative property, we have three elements which are in R, then A dot B dot C equals to A dot B dot C. So it will also hold the property of associative. It means this will also be a semi group. And the third property is of the multiplication that is dot is distributive. This is distributive with respect to addition. So it will have the distributive property. So we can say A dot B plus C equals to A dot B plus A dot C. This is lab distributive law. This is the lab distributive law. And also A plus B dot C equals to A dot C plus B dot C. This is right distributive law. So this ring, that is a algebraic structure, this is the algebraic structure, will be a ring if it has these three properties. First property is R comma plus is an abelian group. This is an abelian group. This is first property. And the second property is R comma dot is a semi group. It will be a semi group. And the third property is multiplication, that is dot is distributive with respect to the addition. So if any set hold these three properties, then that is known as a ring. Now we will see the example. So sorry, before this we will see the types of ring. There are two types of ring. First is ring with unity. That is to say, one belongs to R, comma plus, comma dot. Means there will be a unity element. Then that ring is known as ring with unity. And the second is commutative ring. Means if we have two elements, that is A comma B, then it will be commutative with respect to the multiplication. So we have to remember this. This will be commutative with respect to the multiplication. That is to say, if A comma B belongs to this, then A dot B goes to B dot A. So these are the two types of the ring. First is ring with unity, and second is commutative ring. Now you will see the example. First example is, let us consider R equals to, this is the set of integers, R equals to 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, and so on. So this is a set of integers that is containing 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3. Now we will see whether it is a ring or not. So now we will see the properties. This is the first property, that whether this R plus is an abelian group or not. So first we will see the closure property. Now let us consider two elements of this set. This is the set of integers. The set of integers. So if we consider two elements A, B, let us say 1 and 2, and we add these two, then that will also be an integer, and that will belong to this particular set. It means closure property will hold. Now the second property, associative property, if we take three elements from here, means A, B and C, if we take three elements, let us say 1, 2 and 3, then when we find out A plus B plus C equals to A plus B plus C, then these two will be equivalent. If we find out the addition of these, then they are also equivalent. This is the third property. Third property is identity element. Means here we are taking the identity element is, this is 0. 0 is there because if we add A with the 0, A plus 0, then this is A, and 0 plus A, this is additive identity, and this 0 is there in this particular set. So this property is also present in this. The fourth property is inverse. If suppose 1, A goes to 1, we take this element, then there is inverse. The inverse of 1 is also minus 1, and if we take this 2, then minus 2 is also there. Means this is the property, this is additive inverse property, and for every integer there is a negative integer. So this property also holds. And fifth property is commutative property. A comma B belongs to R, then A plus B goes to B plus A. If we take two elements from this set, then we can easily see that there will be A plus B goes to B plus A. We can take any two elements, like if we take 1 and 2, then 1 plus 2 goes to 2 plus 1. That is 3 goes to 3. So this property also holds. Now we will see the second property. Second property is the set should, this R comma dot is the same group. We will see with respect to the binary multiplication. So first property is closure property. We see this closure property, and we take two elements from this set, let us say 1 and 2, then 1 dot 2 will belongs to R. Means 1 dot 2, 2 dot 3, that will also be an integer. So this property also holds, or we can say this set R is closed with respect to the binary multiplication. And this is second property associated. If we take 3 elements, let us say 1, 2, 3, then it will also hold for this binary multiplication, because if we find out A dot B dot C, then this will be equals to A dot B dot C. So this property also holds. And the third property is multiplication, that is dot is distributed with respect to the plus. So if we find out the left distributive law and we take 3 elements from here, then these two will be equivalent. If we find out A dot B plus C, then it is equivalent to A dot B plus A dot C. And also this is the right distribution, this is A plus B dot C equals to A dot C plus B dot C. So we can say this, we can say that R will be a ring. It will be a ring. Other sets like set of rational numbers, is also a ring. We can also easily find out, we can make a set of rational numbers and we can apply these properties one by one, then it will come out to a ring. So, thank you.